In this video, we're going to start the KutaSoftware Infinite Algebra 1 free worksheet, Solving Systems of Equations by Substitution. I'll leave a link in the description below so you know how to access this free worksheet. Now, we're going to be solving each system by substitution. Essentially, what that is, we're going to be solving for the equation of a variable and plugging that equation in order to solve for the remaining variable. So number one, we're going to be taking what y is equal to and plugging it in for y. Well, y is 6x minus 11. So we'll have negative 2x minus 3 times now y, which is 6x minus 11. So we have y in terms of x, and we're plugging that in for y. And that's equal to negative 7. So because y is equal to 6x minus 11, I'm able to plug that in for y. Now I'm going to have to distribute my 3, and then simplify and solve for x. So I'll have negative 2x minus 3 times 6x, which is minus 18x, and then minus 3 times 11, which is 33, but that will be a negative 33. So plus a positive 33 equals negative 7. Now I'll combine my like terms, which are my x's. And at the same time, I'll subtract 33 from both sides of my equation. So negative 2x minus 18x is negative 20x, and that's going to be equal to negative 7 minus 33, which is negative 40. Dividing by negative 20, I'll isolate my x and get that x is equal to a positive 2, since negative 40 divided by negative 20 is 2. Now that I know what x is, I can plug that value in for my equation that's equal to y. I could also plug it in the second equation, and then solve for y. But since y is already written out, I'll just say that y is equal to 6 times 2 minus 11. So that's 12 minus 11, which equals 1. So my solution in number 1 is x is equal to 2, and y is equal to a positive 1. In number 2, y is equal to x minus 1. So I'm taking x minus 1, and plugging it in for y, since we know what y equals in terms of x. So 2x minus 3 times y equals negative 1. Now I'm going to have to distribute that 3 and then solve for x. So 2x minus 3 times x is minus 3x minus 3 times negative 1, which will be plus a positive 3. That equals negative 1. Now, combining like terms, my 2x and 3x, 2x minus 3x, and then I'll subtract 3 from both sides to move my 3 to the other side of the equation. So 2x minus 3x is negative 1x, and that's going to be equal to negative 4. So dividing by negative 1 will give me that x, positive x, is equal to a positive 4. So now that I know what x is, I'm going to take that value of x and plug it into my equation for y. So y equals 4 minus 1, therefore y equals 3. So 4, 3 is my solution in number 2. And number 3, I'm given that y equals negative 3x plus 5. So I'm going to take that value of y and plug it in for y in my second equation. So I'll have 5x minus 4 times y, which we can write as negative 3x plus 5, and that's equal to negative 3. Now I'm going to distribute that 4, so I'll have 5x minus 4 times negative 3 is negative 12, but if I'm subtracting negative 12x, it will be the same as adding a positive 12x, and then negative 4 times 5, I'll be subtracting 20, and that's equal to negative 3. So I'll add 20 to both sides in order to move my terms without x to one side, and then I'll combine my like terms, 5x and 12x. So I'll have 17x equal to negative 3 plus 20, which is positive 17. When I divide by 17, I'll get that x is equal to a positive 1. So now I'll take that value of 1 and plug it in for x. So y equals negative 3 times 1 plus 5. That's negative 3 plus 5. So y is equal to a positive 2. So 1, 2 is my solution in number 3. And number 4, y is equal to negative 5x minus 17, so I'll plug that in for y. So negative 3x minus 3 times y, which is negative 5x minus 17, that's equal to a positive 3. I'll have to distribute that 3, so I'll have negative 3x minus a negative 15x, or plus a positive 15x, and then minus 3 times negative 17, which will be plus a positive 51, that's equal to 3. So now I'll subtract 51 from both sides. Negative 3x plus 15x is 12x, and 51 minus 51 is 0. So 12x is going to be equal to 3 minus 51, which is a negative 48. So when I divide both sides by 12, I'll get that x is equal to a negative 4. And if x is negative 4, plugging that value in for x for my equation that's equal to y, I'll get that y is equal to negative 5 times negative 4 minus 17. So that's going to be a positive 20 minus 17, which equals a positive 3. So negative 4 for x and 3 for y in number 4. And number 5, I'm given that my y value is equal to negative 2. So since I already have my y value solved for, I'm simply going to plug that value in and solve for x. So 4x minus 3 times negative 2 equals 18. So that means that 4x minus 3 times negative 2 is minus a negative 6, but subtracting a negative 6 is the same as adding a positive 6, and that's going to be equal to 18. When I subtract 6 from both sides, I'll get that 4x is equal to 12, and dividing both sides by 4, I'll get that x is equal to 3. So x is 3, and they give us that y is negative 2 for number 5. In number 6, y is equal to 5x minus 7. So I'm taking that quantity, 5x minus 7, and plugging it in for y in my other equation. Negative 3x minus 2 times 5x minus 7 equals a negative 12. So I have negative 3x, and I'm subtracting 2 times 5x, which is 10x, and then I'll be adding 2 times 7, which is 14. Since subtracting a negative is the same as adding a positive, and that's going to be equal to negative 12. I need to subtract 14 from both sides in order to get my terms without x to one side of the equation. So negative 12 minus 14 is a negative 26, and negative 3x minus 10x is negative 13x. So if I divide both sides by negative 13, we'll get that x is equal to a positive 2, since a negative divided by a negative is a positive. Now that I have the value for x, I can plug that in my equation of y. So y is equal to 5 times 2 minus 7. So y equals 10 minus 7, therefore y equals 3. 2, 3 is my solution for x and y in number 6. Now for number 7, I have two separate equations, but I need to solve an equation in terms of one variable. So let's solve this first equation in y. In order to do that, I'm going to add 4x to both sides. So for this equation, I'll have that y is equal to 4x plus 6. So now I'm going to take that value of y and plug it in to my other equation. So I'm substituting y, that's in terms of x. So I have negative 5x minus 4x plus 6, and I'm subtracting that entire quantity. So I want to leave that in parentheses because this minus is going to be distributed throughout, and that's going to be equal to 21. So simplifying, I'll have negative 5x minus 4x minus 6 is equal to 21. I'll add 6 to both sides in order to move my terms without x to one side of my equation. So negative 5x minus 4x is negative 9x, and that's equal to 21 plus 6, which is positive 27. When I divide by negative 9, I'll get that x is equal to a negative 3. Now that I know x, I'll take that value of x, and I'll plug it in to my equation that I solved for y. So y is going to equal 4 times negative 3 plus 6. So y equals negative 12 plus 6, which is equal to a negative 6. So x is negative 3 and y is negative 6 for number 7. Now recently we've been solving all of these for y and then plugging in that expression that equals y in for a y in another equation and then solving. However, let's try that method for x. So in the second equation, I'll add 2y to both sides. So I'll have that x is equal to 2y plus 11. So now I'm going to plug 2y plus 11 in for my variable x in my other equation. So negative 7 times the quantity that's equal to x, which in this case is 2y plus 11, negative 7 times that, and then I'm going to subtract 2y, and that's equal to negative 13. Now I'll need to distribute that negative 7, so I'll have negative 14y plus negative 77 minus 2y equals negative 13. Now I'm going to add 77 to both sides so that my terms with y are the only thing on the left side of my equation. Therefore, I'll be able to combine my like terms. So negative 14 minus 2y is going to be negative 16y. Negative 77 plus 77 is 0. Negative 13 plus 77 is equal to 64. So I'll divide negative 16 from both sides to get that a positive y is equal to negative 4. So if y equals negative 4, I'm going to plug y back in and solve for x. So I have x equal to 2 times negative 4 plus 11. So x is going to be equal to negative 8 plus 11. Therefore, x equals a positive 3. So in number 8, my x value is 3 and my y value is negative 4. If you have any questions, feel free to leave a comment below. And if you haven't done so already, like this video and subscribe to my channel. All likes and subscriptions are greatly appreciated.